So here in this CCSE, we are going to talk about some special topics of checkpoint. So in this courses, we are going to talk about basically these topics. Okay, so in these 3 days, we have to cover 12 topics. So today we are supposed to finish 4 chapters, and then 4 for tomorrow and 4 for the last day. And how we are going to proceed, I'll be covering these topics. You have a query, please unmute and speak, ask your questions, and then I'll give you a lab to perform all these activities with my guidance. Okay, so lab is good, but we should understand first the concept and then we should do the lab. Perfect. At any point of time you have to say anything, you can say anytime. Okay. So are you ready to start now? I guess yes. So Deepak, I'm starting, and anytime you have to say something, unmute and speak, please. Okay. Perfect.
Okay.
Now this is the topology, Deepak. So in this topology, you can see a GUI is a machine that we are basically trying to use. I'm just going to draw something for your understanding. So what is topology and how we are going to use it? So Deepak, as you can see here, in this topology, we have three major sites. So we have one head office. This is a head office. And this head office has the name Alpha site. And in this Alpha site, we have a firewall. And this firewall is protecting three networks. This is a management network. This is a LAN network. And this is a DMZ network. So all three networks are protected by a single gateway here. And the gateway is connected to a public router. So this is a public router, and public router is connected to internet first. It is connected to internet here, internet. And this router is also connecting to two sites, site Bravo and site Charlie. So Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, there are three sites and one machine on public network. And in these three networks, we have, in these three sites, we have this management server. We have this secondary management server. We have this primary management server. So this is primary, this is secondary, and this is basically a log server. And this AQI is basically the graphical user interface machine. The user is going to log in here. And similarly, in the other branches, we have a firewall protecting one gateway, another firewall protecting another device, likewise. So we are going to primarily focusing on our Alpha site first. Okay, so let's begin. And I request you to have the snapshot here. Let me do one thing. If it is possible, I can take a No, I can't take it as it. So this is one of the topology that we are going to follow in CCSE. Perfect. So what we have in CCSE basically, in CCSE, the first topic, as we now know, is about advanced deployment. Now, so Deepak, you also do deployments. Okay. Now, what is extra here? What is something called advancement? Let's try to understand. Now, so first of all, Deepak, we have, whenever we are going to deploy the checkpoint, we have two way of deployment. First is standalone and distributed. Now, in standalone, you already know that we have one device and we are making this single device both the management server and the gateway. And from CCSA, you already know what is a management server and what is a gateway. So standalone deployment is that type of deployment where on one device, on one hardware, you are going to deploy both the management server and gateway. Now for smaller environment, this kind of deployment may be good. But for bigger environment, you need a distributed deployment. Now, what is a distributed deployment? Distributed deployment is a scenario where you have one device and one device has management server installed and you have another device having security gateway installed. Because both management server and gateways are installed on different machines, so this implementation or deployment is called distributed deployment. And in case of standalone, you have one device and on the same device you have both management server and gateway. So before deployment, you should understand the need of the customer. If customer had a small environment and has a budget constraint, you can go for standalone. Otherwise, Checkpoint recommends that you should go for distributed deployment. Now, whenever you are deploying checkpoint, you have few steps to follow. So whenever you have a checkpoint and you have to deploy, first of all, you should install the Gaia. What is Gaia? That is the operating system. And then you can either make it a management server or a security gateway. So what are they? They are basically the product. So management server product is installed on the Gaia OS. Now, how we can access the Gaia? You may ask a question, Sanjeev, I want to access the Gaia operating system. How can I do it? Now you have two options. First, command line access, and second, a graphical user access. Now for CLI, you can use, let's say, PuTTY, or you can connect to console and you can get the CLI access. But for a graphical, you have to use the browser, and through browser, so let's say this is your device. The device has IP address 192.168.1.10. So connecting to it, you have another machine. Now this machine, we call it graphical user interface machine. From this machine, you are going to type HTTPS. and then you type the IP address. And when you click enter, you will suddenly see a graphical user interface of your device. Okay, so you can access, I told you that you have Gaia as an operating system, and on top of a Gaia, you have product, which means your management server or security gateway. Now, from the CLI or GUI, you can access the Gaia. You can access the Gaia. Now, you may ask a question, Sanjeev, I want to access this management server. How can I access? The answer is, for accessing management server, you have smart console. Now, smart consoles nowadays comes in many flavors. It could be a client, dedicated client that we are using. It could be a portable smart console. It could be a web smart console, but ultimately it will be a smart console. From the smart console, you first connect to your management server, and then you can direct gateway. From the management server, you can guide the gateway what traffic to control. And these are the basic information you should be having from the CCSE. So it is a kind of a revision, a remembrance, so that you become active.
Okay. Yes.
Perfect. Now, Deepak, tell me one thing. Do you know something called API? Any idea about API? What is API and why we use it? So the question is about API. Do you have some idea about it?
API stands for the artificial intelligence.
Application programming interface. Okay.
Okay. I'm thinking different.
No problem. You are here to learn. You are allowed to make mistakes. My duty is to correct. Okay. So API, application programming interface. Yes. If I say what is API, the answer would be API is a new way, is another way of giving directions to your devices. So we know if you have checkpoint, Cisco, or any device, you can connect and give directions either through CLI or through GUI. But API is another way of giving direction. This is a new way. So you may ask a question, Sanjeev, when CLI and GUI were there already, why we need it? Answer is, we need it because we have a new thing called cloud. And every vendor wanted their solutions to be integrated to cloud. So API is a special language that make a device compatible to cloud language. Due to the effect of this API, I can or cloud can integrate checkpoint, and then whatever you want through cloud, you can achieve. So what is API? Another language to communicate to checkpoint devices. Why it is there? Because checkpoint want their firewalls, their management server to be compatible with the cloud. So we have API. Now, Very good. We understood API. But what is automation? Answer is all the changes an administrator do. So as a admin, as a professional, you do so many activities, but there are some activities which are repeatable, which means again and again, same thing. For example, installing the Gaia or installing the operating system. So if you install one operating system 100 times, the steps would be the same. Only some values may change. Rest, everything will be the same. So all the tasks which are repeatable, we don't want human to waste the energy and time for repeatable tasks. And we created automation to do it. So now you don't need to invest your time and effort for those activities which are done again and again. And automation we are using for this purpose. So, and API helps automation up to a great deal. So API and automation help each other. Now, because automation and API help each other, that's why it becomes important for every vendor. Not only Checkpoint is going into this API and automation direction, but also other vendors. So API and automation has become important for us also. If you want to improve over your career, so I would advise you to go for the automation and API, because future is automation basically.